Hey, what's happening, y'all? Here we go. Oh, yeah. Here we go. All right, fellas. We're gonna get going today. On a beautiful Teton guitar. This was purchased about 5 years ago by a young man named John. And he's taken very good care of the guitar. It's got a couple of dings in it, and if your guitar doesn't have dings in it, you're probably not playing it enough. What we had on this one was a string action that was too low and neck relief that was just too flat. I'd made a while the customer was here this today, we created a little bit of a neck relief to get rid of some fret buzz, but in doing that, we raised the string action way a little bit too high. Here, it did raise the string action. So, I'm gonna do some work on this saddle. And let me get this. Okay, yeah, we're all good. Get one of these if you don't own one and you play guitar. You guys have been wasting a lot of time if you don't own one of these. The little tool that pulls the pins. I know y'all know this probably, but if you don't, that's what that's for. I just used it. There we go. Okay, so my measurements tell me that the saddle is a little bit too tall, and it's a bone saddle. Looks like it's in really good shape. I'm kind of inspecting it for cracks and such. Let me get some light on here. We'll turn some light on. There we go. So I need to remove some material off the bottom of this, and I know what my measurements are because, well, I measured it before. I need to take, let's see, 4/64 off the bottom. So let's do this. There's a great trick for getting the exact right dimension off of there. Color a little spot with a Sharpie pen. It's about the only good use for a Sharpie on a guitar, unless you really got a little dot on a black piece of paint. You can kind of hide it with that, although it turns purple. I need to remove 4/64 off of the low bass strings on there. So that would be, what does it work out to? 1/16 of an inch. So off of my bass side of my saddle, I need to remove that much. And now I've scored it. Now I need to take half that much, 1/32 of an inch off of, I'm going to zero this out. Let's find 1/32. 164, 1/32 right there. That tiny little amount will make a score on there. Now I have my dimensions for getting this saddle cut exactly right. And here's what I typically do. I use my, let's get you pointed down here at the work. Get my little straight edge here. This is very, very straight. And my pencil. This pencil being a half mill pencil lead, it's really tiny. So I can get a really discreet, tight line on this. Get her lined up. Just like that. And draw a line across here. And now I know that I need to remove that much material off of this saddle. Now, my bench sander, or my sander, belt sander, I should say, is out in the shop, which is behind me. So I think what I should do here is let me see how quickly I can go out and sand this. I might need to leave you all alone for a few moments here. Hey, Russ, what's up? Brody. Rogue, hey buddy, in from the sky. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, all guitars have to have them, man. I'm gonna run out to my bench, and grind this down. It should take me about 2 minutes. I am going to leave the line because I do have sandpaper here on my bench that I can use to finish it off. I'm hoping the stream is going smoothly today. We're hoping that we've got good good internet connection today. It seemed like yesterday was a little bit odd. So give me a couple minutes. I'll be right back. I don't have anything too terribly entertaining to roll for you while I'm JDL, welcome, brother. Brother or sister, I don't know. I hope you're doing well. Again, I'm going to go out and grind this off. Give me a couple minutes. I'll be right back.
Get it figured out, Mike?
Yes. It was just,
same old problem coming back?
Was that seagull got caught in the door.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a, I was worried it was that stupid,
keeper. Totally, yeah. I think, are you going to have a shot?
All right, well. So our power out in our shop is down. Holy smokes, JDH, JDL, Rody, JDL. I don't think I've met you before, and if I haven't, please forgive me for not saying hello. I'm glad you're here, man. Thanks for hanging. I just went out to the shop and discovered that our power is off out there. So I'm gonna go back to the old, good old normal sandpaper trick here. I'll get you down here where I can get right on it. Got a nice glass surface here, and I'm gonna take this saddle and start removing material. I prefer to do this on a bench sander because it's a whole lot quicker. Sand a little bit one direction, flip it around, go the other direction. Now I know that I've got to take a bit more material off of this on the base side of this saddle, on the low E string. So I'm kind of putting some pressure on that side to make sure that the amount that I take off is accurate. Trying to keep the saddle really straight up and down so that my bottom edge is nice and smooth. And I've got a lot of material to take off of there, so I'm going to be doing the old elbow grease thing for a bit right now. One other thing that I failed to check for in the guitar is to make sure there isn't a shim in there. And I can see that there isn't. Nobody put a shim in that guitar, so I think we're okay. Taking this off. And if not, I've got multiple bunches of these saddles. Alright. Hey Richard, what's up? I'm doing great, Richard. How are you doing? I hope your move has gone well. Are you going to be able to be live tonight? That is the question. Do you know? Richard does his, often he does a Wednesday night live stream. You'll get to enjoy watching him play guitar. Yeah, very cool. I'd be done with this already if my belt sander was on, but I don't have that, so I've got to do this by hand. Lots of bone to take off. You guys love the smell of sanding bone? Isn't it awesome? I got you, brother. I don't know if you all know, but the Falcro has recently moved, and he's been moving for the, you know, definitely yesterday and today, I think, were big days for him in getting his equipment and his recording studio and broadcasting studio all moved. So that's been a... I can't be there to help him, and I sure wish I was. He lives on the opposite side of our great state of Oregon. I think we both love it here. You have to be able to handle some rain if you live here. Isn't this exciting? It takes way so much material off here. But again, our power is off out in the shop. They're doing some work on the building. I'm just going to sit here and grind on this for a bit. We'll get her. And, you know, often I will keep the bone powder in case I have to do a repair on a nut or a saddle where I've got to fill a gap with some CA glue. I can blend a little bit of this bone powder in it and repair a nut on an old vintage guitar or something that I don't want to, you know, pull the original nut off of it out of respect for the age of the instrument. So if you need to make a repair on a nut, like say your nut slot gets a little bit too low, you can use this powder. I have tons of it in a jar, so I'm not worried about this in particular. Keeping an eye on the angle here also to make sure that I keep this surface really flat. Yeah, we're not even halfway there yet. This is 100 grit sandpaper. That's pretty rough stuff. I'm removing material. I'm not doing it for a perfect stain finish or lacquer. Let's see. Yeah. Oh, JDL, welcome. Right on. I have a buddy, Hugh, from Scotland. And... yeah, he talks about it raining a lot. It sounds like our weather here in Oregon is very similar to what you guys experience in Scotland. Welcome to the show, man. It's nice to see you. JDO, I assume you're a guitar player or maybe a guitar tech or both. What's your musical... what's your musical adventure in life? What has it been? I'm curious. I'm getting there. You guys, I'm getting close. I'm gonna leave the line. I don't want to take too much material off of this. Yeah, I'm about halfway. About halfway there. Getting there. This is a workout. I'm gonna have my right arm's gonna be Mr. Popeye here before long. It's not quite the same as pushing drills, plumbing houses, but Gary, what's up? Dude, when that song came out, we laughed so hard in Portland. What was it? 1996? 97? I'm only happy when it rains. Gary, man, congratulations on getting that honorable mention on the Oldies But Baddies contest, dude. That I was so happy to see that. Your song, I think, deserved to win on that competition, regardless of what he had to say. Anything critical, which I will not. That was a fantastic, fantastic, creative take on a song. I did, the creativity in that was beyond the Call of Duty, if you will. That was just awesome. I'm so proud of you and glad to know you. Play basic guitar, sing and warm. Okay, cool. So you play a little guitar, JDL, and that's great to know. Cool. Yeah, Hugh and I have collaborated on a few things. Not much has been released. I think this Friday, I know that this Friday we're going to be releasing some music, a song that Hugh and myself and a couple other heavy hitters, I suppose, if we want to call us a heavy hitter, whatever, work together on. And so we're really excited to see that one get out there. I think Texas Jackdaw and Jack Flash are going to release a song on Friday this week, so that's coming up. And then Hetriani has a release on the 7th, I believe. Help me out with that, Gary. Just kind of doing some ads for people's music coming up. You know, really looking forward to hearing some of that stuff my cuz. We call each other cuz. We're like, I don't know. We'd rather call it cuz than bro. Sleeper group, yep.
Okay,
alright. So I've gotten this saddle all whittled down. Now, normally I would put brand new strings on an instrument when I'm doing this sort of stuff. Okay, and so now I've got a little bit of black ink showing from the Sharpie that I put on here. We'll get rid of that. One of the greatest tools in the history of guitar repair. A scalpel. I don't want to see that, and the owner doesn't want to see that little black mark. Gary, when do you have a new song coming out, man? Do you have something new coming?
New on Sunday, yeah.
Heavy hitters. Right. I'll scrape a little bit off of this end. Get that. So it's not obvious.
I ordered a bunch of new tees.
Woohoo!
A lot smaller
put that saddle back in there. And kind of, here's a little look at what I've done here. Put a capo on up here to hold the strings so that they don't come and wound off the machine heads. Little trick that you can do. Now, of course, this end, the strings will get tangled. They will tangle and tie themselves in the biggest knot. You couldn't even ever even try to tie a knot that good. All right, and we'll go ahead and get the end pins installed. Yep, here we go. I've got to untangle this end of them. At least I don't have to untangle the other end of them. That's a nightmare sometimes. There we go. And we will see how my measurements worked out for me. Shortly. Gary, what do you got coming up? Sith! Hey, thank you. This was a gift from my sister. I love this shirt. I laughed so hard when she gave this to me because I'm not like a big Star Wars freak or buff or anything like that. Of course, I did go watch the movie when it was released in movie theaters in 1976, I believe. 77, maybe? What year was it? 78? I don't remember. It was so long ago. What a huge deal it was. All right. And I'm going to leave that capo on there and snug these strings up. I'm not even going for being in tune. We'll just get them snugged up. Yeah. There we go. East thing out of the way. I like to put a little tension on them so that then they wind around the machine heads so they get nice and tight. Rather than leaving loopity loops. Pooh, what's up, brother? Alright. So you got some stuff coming up, it looks like. Hey, Charlie, what's up? Sith, hello again. JDL, I'm glad you're here. Pooh, glad you're here. Yeah, man. Yeah, it was such a moment. Yeah, the technology has gone beyond. They won't experience new stuff like that. Although the 3D tech that's out is... Again, I would put new strings on a guitar, but this gentleman, my customer, just put strings on 2 days ago, and these things are in really good shape. He does play a lot, so he's worn them in pretty well. I sold him this guitar, I think, 5 years ago. It's kind of cool. He's now a student at the university here in La Grande, Eastern Oregon University. I think he actually might have graduated from Eastern Oregon University by now. May the fourth be with you. Yeah, dude. How did I know? I wasn't really planning on it. Okay, so I've gotten this thing. Use my favorite guitar pick that's always at my bench here. I'm gonna move my camera a little bit so I can play this thing. We will see what happened here. Number one, I'm gonna measure my string action again. I gotta take my glasses off so I can see. 5/64 perfect. 5/64 and 4/64, which is exactly where I was going with the string height on this. Doing there, I'm checking for fret buzz and any fretting out after I've lowered the string action, and I mean I have to really drill this thing. There's definitely something going on there on that D string in particular. The A is really clean. Is really pretty nice. Check them out. Thank you.
Oh, don't stop.
How are you doing today?
Just fine.
We doing some stereo work on one of your cars?
Yeah.
All right. Cool. Cool. All right. I'm doing a live stream on YouTube, so if I'm talking to people, it sounds like it. I'm not talking to myself.
Well, as long as you don't answer yourself.
Right. let's see. Hey JDL, thanks for being here, brother. Let's split down the center of the back. Rody, dude. Yeah, I know. I hear that a lot, man. There's a lot of folks that are a long ways away, and I can't help them. If you're willing to trust some shipping, we could get your guitar in here. I do have some guitars and clients that do ship their instruments to me, so I'm lucky that people are trustworthy. But when they come in, man, they are packed like tanked, just completely covered in plastic and air bubble wrap and rags, towels. It's amazing. Hey, Sean, what's up, brother? How you doing? Oh, it's so great to see you. If you guys, just a little promotion here for Sean and his brother, the Chandler brothers, just fantastic songwriting and production work going on over there. If you don't know Sean or haven't listened to their music, the Chandler brothers, go check them out for sure. And Rody's Jam Cage, I think Rody's been doing some work on getting his recording or his studio system set up. He's done a couple of live streams I've seen just little glimpses of recently. Dude, it's great to see you. Okay. Oh, Hugh and JDL have a premiere coming up. All right, that's cool. Good, good. I'm going to miss that. But I will watch it on the replay. Got this thing pretty well dialed in. Feels really nice to play. I'm gonna let the owner come in and tell me what he thinks. I need to hear him play the guitar because I might be just really digging in. It's interesting setting up guitars for other players. I don't know how they play, you know, so if they're really digging in and hitting the thing hard, it's gonna respond a lot differently than me digging in and hitting it hard. You know how that goes. Yeah. Cool. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and put this one back in the case. I'm going to give it wipe it down, get all my fingerprints off of it. Looks beautiful. This is a Teton model STS 110 CE cutaway. Beautiful guitar. This is our house brand here at our shop. There it is in all its glory. Mahogany neck, mahogany back and sides. They are laminated back and sides. Solid spruce top. Just beautiful. Look at that thing. And he does have dings on it, so he's been playing it enough. That's good. It's like a boat with no dings on it. It's parked in your garage. You ain't fishing out of it unless you're getting dings in it. All right. Let's put this one away. All right. Now my next adventure. We're going to get back to the old, the Ovation. Here it is. Now, yesterday I spent some time on this guitar getting rid of all the glue that the owner had slopped all over this guitar. And got a crack in the top of this one, and I want to stop that crack from spreading. And I don't know what kind of glue this gentleman used on this guitar. It almost acts like it's epoxy, which epoxy is not allowed on my bench. I will use JB Weld once in a great while. Epoxy, absolutely not. And I'm really doing this for those of you wearing headphones, just for your enjoyment. Really got to try and get this glue. It's very rough, a rough edge along here. I apologize for this terrible noise. Man, that's just... All right, now we're getting down into the finish. This is really a rough edge on here. I do have dye that I will hit this with. And any place that I've gone through to kind of hide those marks. We got to make it worse before we make it better. Yeah, gotta do it, man. And it would have been nice if this glue had never been put on this guitar, just had been brought to me just to do the repair. It's really sad, but okay. I'm gonna change my blade here. Keep that one handy.
That's the last year model.
And the cool thing about working on an Ovation like this is I've got access to the top from the back. So there's an access hole, and I will open that up here shortly. But I want to get all this material that I've... Okay, so I can see... This is where stuff gets really interesting. see there's chips of wood down in here and material. There's glue. There we go. There we go, digging away at it. Hey Gary, welcome back. Oh man, yeah, usually you know, this guy, the guy that owns this guitar, number one, he's a very smart man, and number two, he's very handy with the tools, and I know that about him. And when he brought this in, he was very apologetic about having put glue in this already, and we weren't even sure that we were going to go this route on this guitar, but upon further discussion and after repairing a couple of other issues this guitar had, we both decided that we should reinforce this crack and try and keep it from getting worse. So here we are today, digging all the glue out of here so that I can get glue in here to hold this thing together. And we aren't going to go for the full-on cosmetic perfection. Did y'all get over there and check out Hugh's new song that he released today? I will get on there and check it out when I get home this afternoon. I only work until 2 o'clock today, so that's kind of nice. I get to go home and get to work on my new recording projects. I have some stuff that I'm working on. Okay, still got a little chunk here that I want to try and get out of here. There we go. Got it. These little teeny chunks like this are can really keep a guitar from being able to get back together again. Now, my next move. All right, that's looking really nice now. I'm liking that. Definitely some rattle. All right, let me let's look at the back of this thing. I'm gonna loosen this. Now should pop out of here. Maybe I gotta loosen it a bit more. I don't work on ovations a whole lot, so the whole, there we go. There we go. And some dust bunnies. Alright. We can look on the interior of this guitar and see the crack. Lots of little chips, but it looks like, I don't know how well you're able to see what I'm seeing in here. Thank God it's plastic. I was asked what this material is. It's plastic. Dusty. Braces look and feel like they're all still attached. So what's happened is the this crack occurred. It's not on the seam. Not on the glue seam. The crack happened, and I don't know how well you guys can see that, but hey, Red Eye Bloom, what's up? Yeah, isn't that cool? You know, we don't need to worry about this. I've seen these get completely caved in and then pop back out on the backs on ovations. You've probably all heard the stories about, you know, one of them getting dented, and then, you know, all of a sudden they hear a big boom and the dent pops out. JDL, I'm sorry I wasn't able to get to your broadcast today. I will go check it out. You'll get a view from me for sure, man. And I don't think I'm subbed to your channel. I need to do that. All right. So what we're gonna do, what I'm gonna do on this one is I'm gonna build some gussets and glue the gussets in place, and I will use magnets to hold the gussets in place to push them down into the glue. I don't have a way to get clamps on this efficiently enough just because of the shape of the guitar. So I'm gonna put gussets in there. I need to build some gussets. I'm gonna do that out of some Padauk that I've got here. I'm gonna have to thin that out. That's gonna require a bit of work, a belt sander and a bandsaw. And I'm not gonna have that on the video today. Yeah. Cool. Oh, I'm seeing so many. Thank you all for being here today. That's really cool. So I need to build some gussets, and I'll show you what I'm gonna use. Actually, I've got a piece of black walnut here, a really beautiful piece of wood. I used this, I used a piece of padauk on the saddle of the bridge plate in the Gibson, the 53 Gibson. So this is what I'll be using on this. We'll go cross grain against the grain on the top wood so that that wood, that crack, it's, you know, yay wide. I mean, it's literally probably 2 to 3 millimeters of distance in that. I'm going to get a clamp on that to push it together, and then I'll glue the gussets in to keep that thing from ever separating any further. It'll have to break a glue joint in order to do that. So a lot of detail right here. And I'll probably do, I'm looking at probably four gussets in this to get it to where I'm feeling good. Oh, let me go see what's happening with my, okay, everything's looking good. Seems like the stream's going off without a glitch today. Yesterday I had some issues with our internet. Our internet service provider, it's not like they can email me, right? They have to send me a piece of snail mail to let me know that they sped up my internet access at home. It's like I have to receive that mail. And there must be some advantage to mailing people stuff. If I never get another piece of paper mail aside from a birthday card, I'd be okay with that. All right. Whew. Dusty. Get my rag down in here and pick up as much dust and debris as I can. Take a look. I'm going to give you all a look down inside this instrument as best I can. There's the electronics. There's the bridge plate. If you've never looked down inside an Ovation, now you have. Oh, how do I? Ooh, going the wrong direction. There we go. That's what they look like. The output jack. It's an output jack. And the crack. All right. So, I think my process now, probably best to sign off for a bit, get a few gussets built, come back and show you guys how I go about gluing the gussets in. So I think, I just don't want to waste a bunch of air time on that. Okay. Yeah, and I appreciate everybody hitting the like button. That's very kind of you, and I'm glad you like it. Rody, I didn't find any live animals in this one. I've found interesting stuff in guitars. I found a fish the other day. That was the first time I found one of those. Yeah, believe it or not, it was a stuffed fish. And I've found some paraphernalia, some J's, and I found letters from loved ones in truss rod covers. This has been kind of fun to see that. The grandson of a guy that gave his grandson this guitar once put a note underneath the truss rod cover in a, I don't remember what guitar it was. And it was welcoming him into the, there's a religious group, the Masons, maybe not religious, but a group of men, and it was welcoming him into the Masons, and his kid had never seen it before, so that was kind of cool to give that to him. So I find kind of weird stuff in these all the time. Just checking a couple more things. Okay, guys, I'm going to sign off for a bit. I need to make some gussets. You don't want to watch me do that. I'll be back with some gussets built out of this wood, and we'll get them glued in. And I'll be back in a little bit. Thanks for being here. Hit subscribe, hit the notification bell, do all that stuff. I think I'm subscribed to everybody here, but JDL, I'm going to go in and double check that I'm subscribed to your channel. Be sure, it's a secret society. Yeah, something like that. So have fun. I'll be back. Thanks, you guys.